I tell people that they should be able to put a whole presentation, make it really simplified and get to the core of the message. So my whole course is actually on this one postcard, and I give that out at the end because that's like 7 hours of work on one postcard. That's how I want to do it. And it is asking the audience, answering the question, what's in it for me, really early on. Just explain to them, why are you presenting to them? No one wants to have their time wasted. So you want to just tell an audience, look, this is why I'm here today. This is my experience. This is how I'm going to help you. So that then people invest in that rather than just going, oh, what a waste of time. And I've worked with some organizations on there, like induction training, because it's the sort of thing you have to go for. You join a large organization, you have to go there for a day and you have to sit there and watch 16 presentations. And it's always really difficult. And so you've got to tell them why you're doing these presentations. Otherwise, people just fall asleep. You have to understand the core of your message, the purpose of your talk. So you have to get to understand that people might only take away one thing from your talk. So if you decide at the beginning what that one thing is, then it helps your planning and it helps everybody, because then you can repeat that a few times and people walk away with that. I mean, if it's three things, you know, fair enough, you know, A, B or C, but really we all have to get to the core of our message, because that's where death by PowerPoint comes in. Because what people think a presentation is to tell the audience everything they know about that subject, when it should be completely the opposite. A presentation is large brushstrokes. It's strong, big brushing. It's like you're doing a painting on an enormous canvas. You haven't got time for fine little details. That comes out in notes that you can hand out. That comes out in a Q&A. That comes out in chatting to people at lunchtime. What you have to do in a presentation is give them broad brushstrokes and help them to understand this is where we're going, this is it really. And then at the core of what I do really, I guess if all presentation skills courses should be based around story really. And I spend quite a bit of time helping people to understand that story is part of their life, but they've probably never noticed before. And story is a massive part of my life. But it took me years and years to work out how that is. I mean, for some people it'll be Harry Potter. They could have lived their whole life. Younger people have lived their whole life in and around the J.K. Rowling world. For me, it was Star Wars. So my first Star Wars film at age 7. It was just me and my dad, and he took me to see Star Wars. It was like a father and son moment. He just got a brand new company car, and it was a Honda Accord automatic, a beige one, if I remember rightly. And he took me in this new company car, and it felt really posh, because they were quite rare in the 70s. Took me to see this film, Star Wars, and at the end of the film, he said, oh, do you want to put the car into gear, Lee? And we clicked the car. I sort of moved the automatic gear stick into drive, and it felt like I was flying the Millennium Falcon. That when I was 7 years old, and I still remember that, and I tell that story often for people to understand that since the age of 7, I was gripped by Star Wars, and I'm 49 years old now, and the last film is about to come out, the last film of the three trilogies. So story is important, and we need to start using it more. I'm amazed, particularly around public sector, actually, public sector presentations, they've removed story. They just give data and they just narrate things. They just tell people stuff. And actually, we need to understand what a story is and allow it to come alive. And that's a massive part of what I do. And then I just teach people how to plan well using post-it notes and blank sheets of paper. You don't have to go to PowerPoint to plan. If you want to use slides, you go there last. It's actually, you've got to get into the analog world. You've got to buy some paper, get a whiteboard, get a flip chart and some post-it notes, and allow the creative side of you to come out. People, I often see business leaders put in their diary speech preparation, and they put an hour in their diary to prepare a speech for a few weeks' time. And then they just sit in their office and they just sort of go, right, be creative. And they tell their brain to go for it, and they wonder why nothing happens. Allow the information to drip into your brain and use some post-it notes and move things around and marker pens and all that good stuff, really. teach a lot about anxiety. Like I mentioned, it's happening a lot more. I'm seeing people design their presentations because of their anxiety. I see them allowing their presentation anxiety to take over, so that they don't feel able to be themselves. They hide behind a professional persona, behind a uniform, whether that's a suit or a jacket like this, or whether it's an actual uniform. They hide behind that because you've got to allow to be yourself, really. So I always say that I think a great speaker is 125%. That's 100% themselves, still professional. Obviously, you don't want to be inappropriate, but you're going to be professional, but be yourself. People buy the talks that I do, people buy those because they help their staff or their conference. But ultimately, they want, you know, it's wrapped up in a Lee Jackson package. It's me that delivers it, so I have to be myself, and I've learned more and more to be that. But then that's 100%, and then 25% is you have to be a little bit bigger for the stage. You've got to be a little bit bigger when you're up front than when you're not, because otherwise you're hiding behind a lectern or hiding behind slides, and actually it's really dull. So you've got to be a little bit bigger and bolder than you probably are in real life. So that's my whole 6-hour course. You just had that whole thing. Is that enough?